Hello, everyone. Utilizing unlimited LoRA models and masks in a single image specifically for AI art purposes can seem challenging, especially for individuals interested in stable diffusion and LoRA training. But worry no more. If you're enthusiastic about stable diffusion and AI art through LoRA, we have the perfect solution for you. In this YouTube video, we'll show you how to effectively harness the power of unlimited LoRA models and masks to create stunning AI art without solely focusing on in-painting techniques. So, if you're eager to explore the possibilities of stable diffusion and unleash your creativity in AI art using multiple LoRA models and masks, stay tuned, and let's embark on this artistic journey together. Before we dive into today's topic, we want to take a moment to ask you to subscribe to our channel and hit the like button below. Are you ready? You can see that in this image I have used 4 different LoRA models and LoRA masks. 1, 2, 3, 4. We will first look at what is the problem, why we will have this video, and then we will find some solution to solve that problem. In the last video, we have used 3 different LoRA models and masks in one image. If you have not watched that video, you can find the link here or in the description below. But why there is only 3? Can we have 4 or 5 or even more? This is the user interface of the additional networks extension. It supports only one LoRA mask for model. 1. 2. 3. Can we have something like this on the right hand side? One mask for models 1, 2, and 3. And a second mask for models 4, 5, and 6. And a third mask for models 7, 8, and 9. If we can do that, we can have unlimited masks for the LoRA models. To solve this problem, I created a stable diffusion extension for that. I created an sd-webui-lora-masks extension. It does exactly what we wanted, as I mentioned before. Let's try it out. You can find the extension on my GitHub page. The link can be found in the description below. It supports unlimited LoRA models and unlimited masks for the LoRA model. To install, copy the repository URL. Go to the Web UI extension tab. Click install from the URL. Paste the URL here. Click the install button. After installed, go to the install tab. Click apply and restart UI. And then you can find the extension here. There will have no tab here. You can find the extension in the text to image tab. Under the LoRA mask section, you can find the settings here. For models 1, 2, and 3, I give them a mask. For models 4, 5, and 6, I give them another mask. For models 7, 8, and 9, I give them another mask. There are a total of 9 models here. However, there is another tab. You can have 18 models. And another tab. And another tab. You can keep adding more tabs here. How to add more tabs? Go to the settings page. Find the LoRA masks on the left menu. Set the number of tabs you want it. Let's change it to 6. Clicking the Reload UI button will not apply the new settings. We need to stop and program and start it again to load the new settings. When it's done, you can find that there are 6 tabs available here. Today we are going to see how many LoRA models we can use. We will try to use 4 different characters of LoRA models with 4 different clothing. We will use this Keanu Reeves LoRA model, this Kirsten Dunst LoRA model, this Christian Bale LoRA model, this Natalie Portman LoRA model. For the clothing, we will use the Star Trek uniform, the Spider-Woman outfit, another Star Trek uniform, and this kimono LoRA model. In total, we have 4 characters LoRA models and 4 clothing LoRA model. I have already prepared the text prompt. We have Keanu Reeves wearing the Star Trek uniform. Kirsten Dunst wearing a Spider-Woman outfit. Christian Bale wearing another Star Trek uniform. And finally, Natalie Portman wearing the kimono. First, we enable the ControlNet OpenPose model. After that, we set up the mask for all the LoRA models. We will use the new extension this time. I have already set up the LoRA models. We will use this mask for models 1 and 2. The red channel for model Keanu Reeves. The green channel for the model Star Trek uniform. For the second person. We will use this mask. The red channel for model Kirsten Dunst. The blue channel for the model Spider-Woman outfit. For the third person. We will use this mask. The red channel for model Christian Bale. The green channel for the model Star Trek uniform. For the fourth person, we will use this mask. The red channel for model Natalie Portman. The blue channel for the model kimono. You can see that there are some differences from the additional network's extension. Here, we have only one slider to control the weight of each LoRA model. Also, the LoRA model is the same as the file name of the LoRA model. The LoRA models do not need to be put inside the extension LoRA model. The extension will find the model under the standard Stable Diffusion LoRA Models folder. We have set up all masks we needed. Like last time, this text prompt should be ready to go. The chipprint I use today is the base version 1.5 and my only chipprint. Hey there. If you're enjoying the content so far, make sure to hit that like button. And subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. By hitting that subscribe button, you'll be the first to know when we release new videos. Don't forget to turn on notifications as well, so you never miss out. Okay, this is the result. The first person Keanu Reeves seems wearing the Star Trek uniform. However, the second person Kirsten Dunst is not wearing a Spider-Woman outfit at all. The third person Christian Bale seems wearing something like a Star Trek uniform. However, the fourth person Natalie Portman is not wearing a kimono. It's different than the last time we used only three LoRA models. Let's try to use high resolution fix to see if there is any improvement. Okay, this is the result. After the high resolution fix, the face of the person gets better. We can recognize the person's faces. However, the clothing is still not correct. Why the clothing cannot be done correctly? It's because the text prompts affect every pixel in the image. It does not know which part of the image should be rendered by which part of the text prompts. To solve this problem, we can try to use a latent couple extension. I have already prepared the text prompts. We need to separate the image into four regions. Let's visualize it. There are four regions. After using the latent couple, we need to separate the text prompts into four parts also. Each part of the prompts is separated by the word and. The first part corresponds to the first region. The second part corresponds to the second region. The third part corresponds to the third region. The last part corresponds to the last region. Everything else kept the same. Keep using the control net model. Keep using our 4 different LoRA masks for 8 different LoRA models. And with the latent couple extension. Let's try it out. Okay, this is the result. We can see that the first person looks like Keanu Reeves wearing the Star Trek uniform. And the second person looks like Kirsten Dunst wearing a Spider-Woman outfit. Also true for the other two persons. It seems like using the base checkpoint, the result is better. We can try to use a high resolution fix again to check the results. Okay, this is the result. We can see that the faces look much better. All the LoRA models are applied correctly in the image. However, it took a long time to render. But it actually worked. And this is the result. Observation. It worked. However, if there are too many LoRA models, we may need to use the latent couple extension. Also, if we use too many LoRA models, the result may not look good. Conclusion. By using the new LoRA masks extension with the latent couple extension, we can use as many LoRA models and specify their locations in the image as we wanted. However, I found that some clothing LoRA models do not work well when we have many LoRA models in the same image. More. This is just a demonstration of using the new LoRA masks extension. The result may not look as good as using fewer LoRA models. You may also need to try many times to find a seat that works well. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comment below. Thank you very much. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about stable diffusion and LoRA training, hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you never miss a video. I will put up the other video soon. You can also find all the models and images in my Patreon account. The link can be found in the description. Thank you and see you in the next video.